Somehow got the first, so introduce yourself.
It was like my like critique sheets. My 4 fan right here.
Hello, I go by Starwin. Current cosplay is Haruna from Kankali.
Thank you. Nice bow.
All right.
Did you forget your name?
No! Well, actually, the last name. I can never fucking remember it.
Just the first name. just go with it. You're good. This
range. Yeah, but the only preteen years.
So got this. Totally.
You got this.
Please.
I'm Mary Jane, I'm the toughest bitch in fairy tale!
Hi, I'm Sam. These are actually my work clothes. Hi, I like long walks on the beach and.
The Florian, the Florian.
My name is Florian. Also, Chris is my real name. Hello.
Okay. I'll translate for you. My name is Lynn. I am from Melty Blood. Do not mind the cat form. Yeah.
Hey guys, I'm Hina Homada. I'm 14. If you like long walks on the beach and smooth jazz, hit me up.
Hi, I'm Yusuke Hiromeshi, and I'm about to beat up this punk next to me.
We're best friends!
Loser.
So our moderator inspired me that you guys need to do a sexy walk down the hallway now. So, nice boat.
Come on, stop here. Where your music's playing.
Show you stuff.
He's like right here. Come up to me, give me like a high five.
When they're ready, we're gonna have them introduce themselves and do a sexy walk.
So this from my own words, because I promise it's not.
It'll get there. Okay. So, please introduce yourselves.
Yourselves. So,
hi, I'm Cameo Malthia as Kanaki-kun from Tokyo Ghoul.
And let's see a sexy walk down the walkway.
Do that.
Woo! Woo! So! The only note he put for you was 14 years old. Okay, so our judges are gonna ask you some questions. So
I will give some to you. I'm writing stuff.
First question.
Okay, so I'll have the first contestant come up, please. Come into the middle.
That was me. That works too, actually.
Okay. Okay, yeah. So I kind of forgot your name. So what was it again?
How did that?
Oh. Wait, what?
Which one?
The which? Just pick one.
I guess I'm moving there.
Okay. All right. So tell me, what would your character do if they found themselves in some sort of apocalyptic scene? What would be the first thing they would do?
Me and my group would just go after the bad guys and just blow them up with all of our cannons.
The bad guys are all dead. It's the apocalypse. No one's alive. It's just you.
That sucks.
Yeah.
It's under FDA.
All right. Well, give them a round of applause. That was, yeah. All right. All right. Anyone else? Hey, nice contestant. Come on.
Should we do like one question?
It's the same question.
All right. Well, introduce yourself once more, please.
I'm Mira Jane.
Hello.
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 Hello. Anyways. All right. So, what would your character, or however you would like describe it, what would they do if, I guess same question, in the apocalypse pretty much, apocalypse just hit, what do they do?
Everyone's dead already?
Everyone is dead besides you.
Destroy the world a second time because they killed all my friends.
The world is destroyed already. You don't need to destroy it a second time.
Yes, I do. The world started it.
The world is the victim here.
No, that's just what the world wants you to think.
The world is on fire, and obviously they're the ones who caused it.
Exactly! The world totally did it. I had nothing to do with it, I swear. You can't prove anything. Watching you.
Alright. Is everyone satisfied with that?
Yeah?
Alright, cool. Alright, I'll do that. You had a maid, you may come over here.
Oui.
Okay, so I like the way you dress. Okay, introduce yourself one more time.
Hi, my name is Sam. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. What would you do?
Same question.
Same question.
Same question.
Same question.
Alright, so everybody's dead. I assume the internet doesn't work.
I would assume that as well.
Alright, so no internet, no electricity.
Yes, that's kind of the point of the apocalypse. There's literally nothing left at this point.
Alright, so basically, I think I just sleep a lot.
Okay, I can accept that. Okay.
Yeah. Oh. You also look a lot like SMG.
Oh, thank you. I don't know if that's a compliment, but alright, give him a round of applause, please. Thank you. All right, next contestant up. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Introduce yourself.
Vaporeon.
Okay. Same question.
If the apocalypse hit, I'd probably cast Aqua Ring, then scavenge around for some leftovers, maybe use some acid armor to beef up my defenses. Just kind of try to stride it out.
Okay. All right. That works for me. Okay, go back. All right, next contestant, please. All right, I guess I'll have to translate for this one, but, what is your name?
I'm Leo Len.
Same question. I blame our Kuid. I am without cake now.
Sigh.
Or White Len. She's very jealous of me. Can I sleep now? All right.
Wait, what? I didn't
say to come on. No, wait, why are you going back? No, you're already up here, you might as well stay. Alright, okay. So, introduce yourself again. Okay.
Hey, I'm Hiro.
Oh, I've heard that.
How old are you?
How old are you?
I'm 14.
Why are you here?
Wow!
Okay, we really don't care actually about that. Okay, so, apocalyptic scene, same question, everything. Go.
Well, I would take a selfie! Oh my god, everybody okay. Selfie with me!
Perfect. Okay. Alright, apocalypse, you take a selfie.
Yeah,
alright. Alright, awesome. Go. Okay. Selfie. I don't know who you'd show it to, but okay. Alright, next person, please. Alright, so introduce yourself once more.
I'm Yusuke.
Okay, so what would you do in an apocalyptic scene?
First thing I would do is celebrate because there's no one left to tell me what to do.
Woo!
Okay, alright. No one to boss you around? Okay.
Exactly.
Anything else?
No.
Okay, alright. You are your own master at this point. Awesome. Okay, go on back. Alright, please clap, please. Next person up. Alright. Okay. So, introduce yourself once more.
Hi, I'm Kanake-kun.
Okay, and same question, I suppose.
So, everyone's dead. There's bodies
yes.
Everywhere. It smells so good. I want to eat the bodies!
In case you didn't know, she wants to eat the bodies. Okay? Alright, awesome. Alright. Alright. Okay. Oh, it's your turn. Okay. Oh, there you go.
Give up.
I want to know where you would hide the body or what you were doing. Tell me now.
I have no answer.
I'm not saying I killed them and none of you can prove it, but if I did, there wouldn't be a corpse left.
I mean, like, how soon are they dead? Like, how soon after?
As soon as you kill.
As soon as I killed them too. Oh man, I'm a bad person. Shoot. I mean, I guess I would just have to go the Breaking Bad way and eat them.
Woo!
That's in Breaking Bad, right?
Yes, he's still good.
Me and my gang of evolutions have a secret spot. Don't worry about it.
And the rich stone is the body hidden. He's icy or beefy. I accept that. The body is a cake. Delicioso.
Well, I guess there wouldn't be like a lot of slots open in my house, so I guess Tadashi's room would be the only place we could hide the body.
There's like a little screen, you know?
No one's gonna notice. He's got one Asian change behind. He's not the separate room. He has no response.
I usually just leave it lying there and everyone congratulates me for a job well done, so I don't see a point to hiding it.
He's good for me, I guess.
I'm not really used to looking at corpses and they smell so good, but I'd take it back to the coffee shop and we provide a lot of services for people.
Are you talking your coffee shop with Tadashi and Heroes?
My coffee shop, we serve a different clientele.
He's good to answer.
Okay, you guys have to come up to me when I ask you this question because I'm not as nice. But if you were a visual novel protagonist, what route would you go for? Name the trope.
Oh.
Ooh.
Boat isn't an answer.
I'm trying to reach the commander's heart.
It's a boat.
It's a boat girl. Is it a boat? Is it a girl? Oh, I'm not gonna call on you. You gotta work for it. Come on.
Oh, I have no idea what you're talking about. So go run along.
Is that your answer?
Hold on. Yes. Yes, it is.
Turn off the microphone.
Okay.
Oh, thanks. All right. Is this an arrow build? Like, is it an age visual novel? I mean, my answer will vary.
Do you want to see an R18 visual novel? Because it can be.
All right. So assuming it
just keep
is,
it, just keep it.
Just keep it PG when your answer.
Oh, okay. So PG.
Only dramatic murder music in here. Like,
let's see.
Go
for me. Get laid, get paid, Gatorade.
That's not a trope.
I usually prefer the coup d'etat, honestly.
Okay. Thank you for an actual answer.
There we go.
I can't, like.
Visual novel.
Yeah, visual novel.
Yeah,
visual novel. The contract route or the naughty route? Blush. You're like 14 years old.
You're all 14. This is inappropriate.
He's a genius.
Yeah.
Just altered a little.
I'm in college.
He's in college. So, like, a visual novel, like, dating, you mean?
Like a dating sim.
I guess someone that was nice and, like, light yellow and fashion, maybe? I don't know.
No one knows.
Next 14-year-old.
I'm not completely sure what you're talking about, but I guess it'd be the one with the big muscles.
Does that work? That works.
And Connie. I don't know if I'd really be a protagonist, but I think it would have to be a tragedy.
I don't know if I'd really be a protagonist, said Kaneki Ken, 2K15.
My dream is to keep Kamala, keep my sister Kamala happy. Follow her, wherever she goes, wherever she has problems, but I'll help her when the commander's hired.
Same question.
Oh, what was it? I didn't care.
What is your dream?
My dream is to become the guildmaster of Fairy Tale and take care of my brother and sister.
No?
No?
Why not?
Mine!
Oh.
Oh. Well, come on then. Bring it!
Have ideas on the other ways we can sell with the best.
Settle on the best!
No, 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 no.
Fist fight.
I kind of like this. Actually, knees. You have to knee each other. Next, please.
No, shut up.
What's my dream? I a lot of times have a recurring dream about like flying. That'd be pretty sweet if I could fly. I mean, yeah, flying would be pretty sweet actually. Like, yeah, can we make this happen, please? Like, I mean, like not like in a plane, but like, I mean, hydraulics would work too. Honestly, like, any actually, no, I'm scared of heights. You know what? I guess my dream would probably be like when I could think of a better dream. That'd be a good one.
Same question.
My dream is to protect my party, to make sure they don't have to take any super effective hits, you know, kind of tank it out for them, maybe pass a wish on.
Okay. My dream is to be able to talk. It is hard to write this fast. If not that, lots of cake.
Same question. All right, my dream would be to like graduate college, become a billionaire, and then buy a sweater that fits me. I think my dream would be, I think it would be nice to grow old with the woman I love. I mean, wait, no, no one heard that. I want to beat up every demon in the universe. Yeah, no one should say.
Well, I had an accident a while ago and I kind of wish I could go back to how I was before that, but since that's not possible, I'd like to just figure myself out, figure out where I belong, how to belong, diet issues, yeah.
Maybe color.
Yeah, maybe.
Thank you.
Okay, contestant number one. If you were a Pokemon, which Pokemon would you be and why?
That's a hard question. Be in the boat.
What?
SSN
is the answer. I can't accept it.
Ditto, so I can change into anything to beat you up. I want him, he's mine.
Rock to the daycare.
What?
You guys
have to
fight each other.
No! Go away!
Actually, it's okay. We have each other.
Look at Tom.
Why?
I'm pretty sure this is a PG panel, so that one can't be an answer.
No. Like ice cream.
Yeah. Ice cream's good. I like ice cream.
For ice cream, right. Got it. So, next contestant. Which Pokemon would you be and why?
Arcanine.
And why?
Zed Extreme Speedzilla.
Judge's accent just mysteriously changed. Why do you want to be an archetype?
So I can finally match my fiery passion.
I gotta get ice.
Nine. That's not a Pokemon. It is a Pokemon? Okay. Okay. Alright, so I'd be like cosplay Pikachu the tough version so we can solve our muscles together and sweat! And that's it. Cosplay Pikachu. I don't know exactly which one I would be, but I would be a fighting type, so I can keep hitting stuff.
Champ.
Whatever. Well, it's a bit of a downer, but I think I'd be like a Mewtwo. I related to him a lot. He doesn't really know where he belongs. He's really not a Pokemon. He's kind of a Pokemon and a creation at once. It's like, if you're two things, where do you belong? So, Mewtwo.
He's also not the Smash anymore, so...
He will be!
Yes. Yes.
Oh, I'm so excited!
Okay.
I want to know how you would feel if the blood of the person you killed is all over the floor. I need suggestions.
I don't know if I'm going to accept that as a question.
Well, we can, how is that an idea?
Because we don't want to give them ideas. We're going to give them ideas because then they'll be like, oh yeah, I learned it here. This is how, exactly how I learned how to hide the body and clean up the mess. Next question is going to be, where do you stash the murder weapon?
Don't give them what we're going to ask.
Okay.
I think the more appropriate question for us is what is the
Exactly. Why don't you assume there's a murder
weapon?
We're not going to ask them how to kill people. Don't want to
know.
No.
Show their acting
skills.
How about we have a dance competition?
Okay.
Okay. How should we do this? Should we have, like, everybody there doing it, or should they come up and show us their moves?
Show me your moves.
Yeah!
Show me your moves.
I enjoy them.
I appreciate you guys.
I appreciate everyone that made that.
Dance off.
Thank you.
Are we having a dance battle?
Yes, we're having a dance battle.
No! One-on-one, winner.
Okay, so I guess, should we have them each come up and do their own dance, or should we all? Okay, all the same time, so guys, come on, Tia.
Girls be looking like they don't mind. I'm here to the beat, walking down the street, and my new free. Why?
Oh, they're working together!
Wait, what? Oh, oh. Are they just that dirty right now?
The microphone. I was trying to be hip, but I'm gonna give the microphone to Muffin, and you're gonna talk to her. But this is my question, because I don't want to give up. So you have to tell and keep it PG. So you have to tell us your best.
That takes out like all of my jokes.
Yeah, you gotta think. Let's be creative.
Okay, be funny.
PG, Nickelodeon PG.
I don't blame you after that
troll. If Vader's name is Nickelodeon!
You can make it Vader's.
Well, no, I'm just saying there were jokes about ripping someone's organs out and eating them.
Yeah!
I mean, whatever floats your boat. Speaking of boats.
You just have to set that up.
Also, no puns. I'll punch.
Where's Bart? Just go.
Punch that.
My God, they'll send you to the penitentiary.
Can we just call it a joke?
Save that.
You just call
it a. Is my mic back on? Okay, so.
Boat.
You can pass and come back to you if you need time to think about it. Okay.
Take a pass.
If everybody passes, it defeats the purpose.
No, because it gives us more time to think, because if everyone passes, then...
So then we'll go full circle. Okay, so let's take a moment for everybody to say pass.
Oh, sure.
Nadal, can you have... Good on you.
All right, guys, I don't actually have a joke, but the funniest thing happened the other day. So I was driving down the road, and I saw a car, and I'm like, whoa, dude, I'm in a car, too. And then I realized, like, we're in metal boxes going down the highway, like... 80 miles an hour, and that's pretty crazy, right? Also, why did the chicken cross the road? To go somewhere.
Okay.
I mean, next.
He's not wrong.
Yeah, we can't even say anything.
Two scientists walk into a bar. The first scientist is like, hey, can I get H2O? Bartender's like, yeah, here's a glass of water. That's cool. Why'd you order like that? That's weird. And the second scientist walks up and is like, can I have H2O2? He died.
Ha! I get it, Kevin.
Ha! Water puns. Water jokes.
What are you waiting for? Get the next person up.
Thank you. Thank you for the
pick. Hey, guys.
Okay, so I've got a joke. So there are three guys driving down the highway, and then there's this huge car crash. Like 500 people die. It's awful. And so the guys go home the next day. They're driving down the highway again. You know, do 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 do. They live, by the way. That wasn't clear. Stay with me on this one. It's kind of long. So the three guys are driving down the highway again. And then suddenly there's this huge car crash again. Like 600 people die. There's blood everywhere. It's awful. And only those three guys live. So Death comes up to them. He feels like those three guys cheated him. And so Death says, as a revenge, he's going to tell those three guys how each one of them is going to die. So the first guy, he says, you're going to die a fiery death. To the second guy, he says, you're going to die a watery death. And to the third guy, he says, you're going to die an odd and very unusual death. So a few years pass. The guys have kind of forgotten about this. They go out, they get married, they do whatever. So the first guy, he's got his first kid. They're playing in his house. They're playing like little action figures or whatever. It's so cute. And suddenly like the house catches on fire. They left the oven on. The birds are gone. They die. So the second guy. So the second guy. He's got a family too now. They're on vacation in Hawaii. And they're surfing and it's great. And there's only this huge wave. And the second guy dies. He's dead. Watery death. Done. So by now, the third guy's heard about his two friends' death, and he's freaked out because he knows he's gonna get it. So he drops off the grid, he cuts all relations with everybody, and he just moves far away. He's quiet, he's safe, he lives in some remote area, he's in his little hut, doesn't talk to anybody. So one night, he's reading by the fire, candlelight, it's pretty good, relaxing, and he hears a knock at the door. He waits. He hears another knock at the door. He waits again. Third knock at the door, and he says, who is it? And then the door bursts open and there's a coffin with arms and legs and it starts chasing him around the hut and he's screaming. It's like, oh my god. And so he runs into the bathroom, he opens the cabinet, and he throws NyQuil at the coffin because NyQuil stops the coffin.
Does that make them an eyewitness? mind blown. Similarly, if somebody's working security in a Samsung store, does that make them a guardian of the galaxy?
I'm so sorry.
What did the bull get when he was late for dinner?
The cold shoulder.
Oh. Water joke.
Water jokes.
Water?
Water you're talking about.
So, there are three construction workers. They're sitting on top. They're having lunch. One of them pulls out a quesadilla and goes, god damn it, if I have quesadillas dead, I'm gonna jump off this building. Next guy pulls out a sandwich, says, god damn it, if I have a sandwich dead, I'm gonna jump off this building. Next guy pulls out a burrito and says, god damn it, if I have a beer dead, I'm gonna jump off this building. So they all come back the next day, and what do you know, the first guy has a sandwich. No, second guy had a sandwich. Someone had a sandwich. Yes, the first guy had a quesadilla, the second guy had a sandwich, third guy, so they all jump off. The wives are there at the funerals, all crying, so they had a shared funeral because the company's cheap. They do pay for funerals, but they don't tell you, and they only pay like $5.
Is that the joke?
No! No skipping my punchline! It's horrible, and you'll listen to the entire thing.
As you were.
So then the wives are crying over Grace, except the one who had the sandwich. And they're like, if only I had made this, and then if only I had made that. And then the third one's like, I don't really care, he made his own lunch.
Okay, so are you sure?
Yeah, I don't.
Okay, so we have one last question and we are going, and the judges are going to deliberate and decide our winner. And that question is, if you win, what are you going to do?
With the magic tiara.
Yes.
You got this.
Passing this around.
I win, I would request. I'll see if I can be able to request them. See if I can be able to request some leave from time off, and hopefully be with the commander. And
getting
up, right? Hopefully get a remodel, yes.
I swear to God, this has anything to do with my boyfriend.
No, not this time. There's more important things.
Okay.
Not many, but there's a few.
Shots are fired.
If I win, one, I'm gonna take him.
I said it!
Yes, but that's not the important part. See, the more important part is I'm gonna take my crown and I'm gonna shove it in Urza's face so bad it bleeds.
So like?
Yes! It's a good big crown, right? I don't want it to break.
I don't think it's gonna survive that.
Are you sure?
I'm pretty positive. While you're playing with me.
Well, fine, then I'll just wear it and punch her in the face.
Yeah.
You should get better crowns. Maybe then your boyfriend would stay with you.
Shots fired.
I'm sorry you had to find out those
games. I actually probably should have gone like a half hour ago. I'm supposed to be rehearsing for Anime Live. I'm also going to call my mom and let her know I was, in fact, the prettiest girl.
Probably take some time off, go hang out at the Battle Resort, you know, be the very best that no one ever was.
Nobody ever won the best.
No, he only won one badge in the first season.
He was given all of the badges.
He totally cheated.
He's
on
his team.
For the record, that's how I got every single badge at Tayo. I was just like, please give me the badge. To my master, he likes to be a pretty princess, giggles.
Well, if I win this pageant, I'm gonna get a tattoo and shave my eyebrows. Woo!
That's what you choose.
I guess if I win, I'm gonna go up to that old hag Genkai and tell her that I am worth something without her.
Yeah.
Did girl walk to her grave?
What? She's not dead.
If I win, I'm probably gonna have to avoid Tsukiyama even more because now I'm award-winning, and I have this stalker, his name's Tsukiyama, he's obsessed with me, and he's into things that are special or different or
and he's ugly.
Anything elevated, so if I win this, I'm just gonna have to avoid him more than I always do.
Did you know that Tsukiyama means trash can in Japanese?
That's so fitting.
I told that to 20 people this weekend and all of them have believed me. You guys are all too trusting.
It doesn't.
Did you have gullibles written on the roof right there?
Okay, so our judges are gonna go deliberate and I have a joke for you. So you guys have like...
Smokey the Bear.
Okay, so I was reminded of my favorite joke earlier.
Just because you said
that. Oh god.
So, there was this guy.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Yeah.
And he loved this girl, and he finally worked up the courage to ask her to prom. He was really, really excited to take this girl to prom.
Okay,
and
what are we talking about?
She said yes, and he was super excited, but because he was so, like, anxious to ask her out, he waited until the last minute, and prom was tomorrow, and he had to do all these things before prom, and he was really behind on time. And so, first, he goes to the flower shop, because, you know, you need to get roses, a corsage, a bunch of flowers. And so he goes to the flower shop, but when he gets there, everybody else waited in the last minute, and there was a huge line. There were tons and tons of people. And he was worried he wasn't going to make it in time, but he waited in line, maybe an hour or two passed, and he finally was super, super happy, and it went well. Then he needs to rent a tuxedo because he needs a tuxedo to go to prom or a suit even. And so he gets to the suit shop and he gets there and there's a huge line again and he has to wait hours and hours because it has to get fitted and all this stuff. And so it takes forever because there's a huge line. And he eventually gets his tuxedo and it's perfect. It's the perfect color. It matches her dress. Everything's great. And so finally, he needs to rent a limousine because he is classy and needs a limousine. So he gets a limo shop, and once again, there's a huge line of people who need to rent limos. And he waits in line, and he waits and waits, but he eventually gets his limo, and it's like an hour before prom's about to start, and everything's perfect. It comes together in the end. And so he gets in his limo, goes to pick up his girl, they go to prom, they're dancing, having fun, chillaxing, relaxing, maxing.
Latin all cool, shooting some people outside the school.
And so they're dancing and they take a break. And she turns to him and is like, I'm thirsty. And he's like, okay, I'm gonna go get you something to drink. So he goes to the punch bowl and there's no punchlines.
I can't believe you told him that joke!
I got a joke.
You gotta take a line. Hey, who wants to hear a pickup line? You're hosting, you're hosting.
Jack, I have a little serving cup with you.
Sorry.
It's all mine.
It looks like really good, too. So how's it work, carrying all your stuff and trying to photo it?
Like anyone asks me for pictures.
Oh. And on our winners, and I don't want to announce, how about our reigning queen needs to hand, we have new crowns. So, last year's winner will pass down,
Can I do the king's crown because I'm prostitute?
Yes, sure. Sure. We have a tradition for whoever wins. We would like you to be a judge next year. That's how we have done it every year. So
hopefully you live here.
Hopefully, yeah. If you win, you don't have a choice. You're coming back next year. Sorry you had to find out this way. So.
Oh, yeah. Yay! You guys are all really great, but I felt that Len really captured the spirit of cross-dressing. She was very feminine, very cute, very in character. And I have the king's crown. We actually got the crowns backwards, but that's okay. So, I don't know, the queen gets the bigger crown, so that's fine. But I'm gonna do the same thing that you did, because that was cute. You guys should all close your eyes.
There's a trick to this, you
guys. Oh! Oh!
I did that! We're going back.
Was off. That was really hard. You guys were all like a tie. That's why we took so long.
Yeah.
But no, you guys were all really in character and perfect. But I don't know, Kaneki's dance, we couldn't say no. But we actually also have another, because you guys were so good, we have another prize for the crowd favorite, which is Sam.
Yeah!
And also, if you stop by my booth in the Artist Alley, 829, I will give you a bow for free.
Winner is here.
Here, you gotta wear this. Oh, you actually need this here.
That's right.
Beautiful.
Oh my.
Beautiful.
It's perfect.
It's perfect. It brings out his eyes. There you go. Woo! conversation with the judges?
Queen among men.